creeper has set up her nest right on top of that Gembreaker's cave. So now they're trapped in there. No wonder they're freaked out. Thunder understands. He's missing his family too. So he's gonna help free the Gembreakers trapped in the cave. The Fall Ripper is just scared and confused like everybody else. Her world has been turned upside down too. Thunder needs to get the Fall Ripper away from the Gembreaker's cave. Take a rest and fly away. She's going to recover. Thunder has to keep the pressure on. Understands. She's got to find another spot to build her nest. Aww. Will you look at that? The Gembreakers sure are grateful to Thunder for his help. But now that he sees them reunited, Thunder wants to keep looking for his family. But hey, looks like maybe he won't have to go at it alone. This brave Gembreaker is Plowhorn. Since Thunder helped her family, it's now Plowhorn's turn to help Thunder find his. There aren't very many dragons that have as big a heart as Plowhorn. Gembreakers can be pretty bullheaded. That also makes them super brave, and the best of friends. As long as Thunder sticks close to Plowhorn, he's got a fighting chance. Oh yeah! Check it out! This crystal beacon can finally guide Thunder and Plowhorn out of this region. Come on, come on, come on! This huge blizzard is nothing! You can do it! Wait a minute. There's something weird going on around here. Why are there no dragons fighting over the fire crystals? Where's everybody gone? Wow. huge screaming death! Everyone must be hiding from her. The screaming death is about as scary as it gets. But Thunder and Plow know that together they'll have a fighting chance. There, Plow Hunter!
Oh, man.
victory for nothing? Looks like Plowhorn has run out of juice, and she can't light the depleted crystal core. How will they escape from the storm? Oh, look at that! Maybe with a little help from their friends! Yes! You know it! And it looks like Thunder and Plowhorn are about to make a two-for-one new friend. These two heads are wooing way, and they know everything there is to know about crystals. Okay, let's regroup for a sec. If the area isn't safe, Thunder's family won't be here. But hey, maybe that oversized Skrill might know where they are. She's gotta be hunting the nightlights, right? Now, where did that big dragon go? Hold on. Skrills definitely are not big fans of taking lava baths. No. It's a catastrophic quaken, and it looks pretty angry. Quaken's gotta be the reason why the lava's rising. And he's probably all worked up, because the squirrels are trying to move in on his turf. But no matter how massive that catastrophic Quaken is, Thunder and his pals are blast. Titanwing Skrill. If only she was around. Finally, here is... nobody? Where's Thunder's family? Where is that nightlight hiding? Wait a minute. Now who's this dragon? Oh, I see. She was imitating the sounds a nightlight makes. She's something else entirely. Aw, Thunder. She was just playing with you. Thunder isn't even angry, just a bit disappointed. But now he doesn't know where to start looking again. Or does he? If she knows what a nightlight sounds like, that means she's probably met them somewhere. and she can lead Thunder to them. Thunder can tell he's made a new lifelong friend. Her name's Feathers, and together, these four dragons are unbeatable. Resonating with the crystals. That's what's happening. How can our dragon stop this craziness? Dragons to her hunting ground, hypnotizing them with her powerful song. And now her friends might become her next meal. Everything he's been through, he's got to win this battle. He's almost there. The Titanwing Skrill is also determined to win. Come on, Thunder. Thunder's not alone. Working together, they'll win the day. The comet is long gone, the earthquakes are over. The nightlights can finally rest in their new home. Everybody will enjoy this well-deserved peace. their world is about to change. And a new story begins.